Morning students, we will again continue with our chapter 6, enhancing a presentation. In our previous video, we have learned how to apply animation effect and transition effects. In today's video, we will learn how to insert audio and video files. Adding an audio clip, how you can add an audio clip into your presentation. So to add an audio clip from your computer to a slide, first you have to click on the insert tab. So I'll just click on my insert tab over here and you will see there is an option in the media clips. You can see there is a sound option over here. But if you have a latest version of your Microsoft Power Presentation, then you will have an audio option in the media group. So over here, I am having the sound option. So I'll click on the sound option over here and you can select sound from file. So the audio will be selected from my computer and it will be inserted into your PowerPoint presentation. Now simply click on this sound from file option and you have to locate and select the desired audio clip where it is stored in your computer. So I have already located my file location. And I'll click on my file location over here and you will see it will prompt the message, how do you want the sound to start in the slideshow. So I'll click on automatically. So you will see the particular sound or the audio have been added to my current slide. Now we will see how we can record an audio clip. To record an audio clip, again, you have to click on the insert tab and you have to go to the media group and there is an option of sound drop down menu and you can see at the end we have a record sound option. But if you have again the latest version of Microsoft PowerPoint presentation, then there will be an option of record audio in the media group. So you can click on the drop down menu and you can click on the record audio option. So when you click on the record sound option, you will see a dialog box appears on your screen. Now simply click on the record button to record your voice. Now you see over here. So we are doing a presentation of chapter 6, enhancing a presentation. So now I have clicked on the stop buttons once you have finished your recording. Now you can click on the play button also to preview the recorded clip. So you can click on play. So we are doing a presentation of chapter 6. So in this manner you can preview your recorded audio clip and you can simply click on OK and you will see that your recorded audio clip is inserted into the slide, which is indicated by a sound icon like this. So you can drag the sound icon anywhere on the slide. So you can drag it anywhere according to your requirement. So you can see in the sound dialog box, you can see there is a play option, there will be a stop option, there will be a record button. And as soon as you click on this, you will see additional tabs will appear on the ribbon under the audio tool. We will have two additional tabs, format and playback. If you have a latest version, so two tabs you can see over there, you will have a format and a playback option over here. So I have only option over here. In the latest version, we are having a playback option over here. So this additional tool is a contextual tab. It's created when you insert an audio clip into your slide. So in this tab, you can see you can click on preview button over here. That is a play button to listen to the preview of the sound. There are various other options also under the audio. Options over here, you can see there is a volume option over here. You can click on the volume. It allows to adjust the volume from low, medium, high or mute option. So this is how you can click on the volume option. If you want to start it, you can click on the start. It controls whether the audio is played when you click or it begins automatically or it play across the slide. So these are the options that are present in your start and your play across slide. So what is the use of this play across slide? It continues playing the audio file across multiple slides. And there are other options also, like hide during the show. It hides the sound icon during the slideshow. You can hide the sound icon also. And there is loop until stop. So it continuously replays the audio clip until you stop it. And there is another option also, that is your rewind after playing. It is the in latest version of your PowerPoint, that it returns the audio clip to the beginning when it finishes playing. So you can again rewind it after playing the audio. So this is how you can add a audio clip or a recorded audio clip to your PowerPoint presentation. Next, we will see about adding a video clip. To insert a video clip from your computer, again you have to click on the insert tab present over here. You can click on the insert tab and you can see there is a movie option. Okay, so you can click on this movie option. If you have latest, in the latest version they will have a video drop down arrow. So you can click on the video arrow and you can see in the media group, and you can see there are various options: movie from file, movie from clip organizer. And there is another additional attachment to your video drop down arrow, that is online video. So you can insert a video from the internet also. So this is the advantage of the latest version of your PowerPoint. But here I am using the movie from a file. So I'll click on this option. And this option, you can see, opens the insert video dialog box. And you can locate it, locate the desired video clip. And you can click on the video clip. And you can insert it into your particular slide. Again, the Microsoft PowerPoint presentation slide will ask you how you want to play the movie in the slideshow. So you can click on automatically, so it automatically the clip will be added to the particular slideshow. So you can click on the play pause button to play the video. So we'll just resize the video. You can resize the video also over here in this manner. So you can see, as soon as the video is added, you will see an additional contextual tabs will appear on the screen. Again, we are having a format and a playback option that appears on our screen. So another, this additional tab, you can have play. You can see over here we have a play option. To watch the preview of the video, click on the play button in the preview group. So you can click on this and you will see a preview of the video appears on your slide. Next option, we are having a volume. Again, you can set the volume of the video using this option. Then we have a start button over here. Under the start, you can see it controls the video file. You can play automatically, you can click on click, or you can click on play across the slides again. And there is an option of hide during the show, so you can hide the video while playing the video. And then we have a loop until stop, so it continuously replays the video clip until you stop it. Okay, then we have a play full screen. This option lets the video play on the entire screen. So if you want the entire screen video, you can click on this option and it will play a full screen video over there. And there is an option of rewind movie after playing. It returns the video clip to the beginning when it finished the play. So in this manner, you can see the additional tabs and you can add a video clip to a particular slide. The next we will see, that is the last topic of your today's video, that is rehearse timing. So what do you mean by rehearse timing? This feature lets you record the run time for each slide in a presentation. So if you want rehearse time feature, you can record the run time for each slide in a presentation. So what the PowerPoint does, it automatically picks the set timings to run the presentation in actual. To set rehearse time, what you have to do, you have to click on the slideshow tab over here. Click on the slideshow tab and you will click on the rehearse option over here. We have a rehearse timing in the setup group. You can click on this and you will see the recording toolbar appears at the top left corner of the screen. So use various commands that are available in this toolbar to record the timing of your presentation. Now we have a next button over here. This next button, it advances to the next slide. So when you click on this, you can advance it to the next slide in this manner. Okay, then we have a pause button. it pauses the recording. You can pause the recording also using the pause button. Then we have a show time. It shows the slide time, which is a particular time. And then it's a re-record time also. It re-records the slide. If you want to re-record a particular slide, you can re-record it using this button. Then we have a show total time recorded for presentation. And you can see this total time is there for the recording of the presentation. So now when you reach the end of the show, I'll just show you. So when you reach the end of the show in this manner, and you can see a prompt message will display on the screen. It says the total time for the slideshow was 1 minute 4 seconds. Okay, so you have to click on yes if you are satisfied with the recording time, else you can select on no. So I'll select on the yes, and you will see the particular rehearse time will appear on my screen. So in this manner, you can add any audio clip, you can record any audio clip, you can add a video clip, and you can use the feature of rehearse timing that lets you record the run time for each slide in a presentation. Now suppose you want to start the presentation. Now you can see over here, this is my particular presentation over here. So this is how you can enhance a presentation using the features of Microsoft PowerPoint. Till then, students, this your chapter completes. So till then, thank you so much.